We're going to demonstrate how rain moves across and through soil depending on the management type we've used. I've got two paired samples of soils to demonstrate today. This first pair is from Treasure County, and I have a reduced till field that was in a small grain and planted to a cover crop, got a lot of residue on it. Right next to it, there was a corner of a tilled beet field. These are clay loam soils, so we can compare how they perform. This pair on the far end are right across the road from each other. This one over here has been a no-till system for about 10 years with continuous cropping. And then right across the road is a tilled fallow system. Both of these systems are the same soil type, they're silt loams. So after an inch of rain, let's look at our paired irrigated samples. Our reduced till sample that had a lot of residue and some cover crop planted into it had hardly any runoff. This sample over here that was right next to it, look at all that runoff that we've got. So the challenge with this runoff is you're losing valuable sediment and organic matter. And what's going with that organic matter and sediment are nutrients. Now let's talk about infiltration. This is the water that actually gets down to where the plant roots are and helps your crop grow. On this reduced till sample, look at how much of that water infiltrated. On our tilled sample, same amount of rain, but we have much less infiltration. So let's take a look at our dryland samples. Here we've got a lot of runoff coming off that tilled field. On our no-till field, we do have some runoff, but certainly not as much. And notice it's a little bit lighter. There's not as much sediment coming off the field. And also, it's not quite as foamy, indicating that it's holding onto its organic matter better. We've got our tilled fallow sample, and you can see that not a lot of water is moving through that soil profile after an inch of rain. And here we've got our no-till sample with a lot of residue, and you can see that about twice as much water is actually soaking in to the soil profile, getting down to those plant roots. We know that if we can follow the five soil health principles, we're going to have less runoff and more infiltration into our soils.